So we're going to speak about data visualization, specifically in the context of Oracle Application Express development. The reason we're giving this webinar is really that DV and Apex make a very nice combination. Most of this will be a demonstration of DV itself. We'll also show you how Apex and DV are integrated technically, how it all hangs together. But I want to start with creating a bit of context. So what are the typical issues we're facing with reporting with Apex alone? And the key things that DV brings to solve those shortcomings. Now, after the demonstration, we'll look at various different products that DV is integrated into, because you have various options depending how far you want to go with your reporting. Now, you could either choose a very quick solution only on your Apex application, or maybe you even want to create a full enterprise BI solution. Huh? You have all the options. The important thing here is that the end user are in control. So the end users can change the reports if they want to, or they can even build completely new ones. And that's a simple principle, but it's actually very powerful, because for the end user, it means that they can answer the questions on the fly without any waiting, without any development cycles. Now, another important thing that you get with DV is the possibility to combine multiple sources. So really see it as a place where the end user can experiment with data. DV can be used on top of one single application, really what we've been discussing so far, on top of your Apex application. But you can also go a step further. You can really make it into a centralized business intelligence platform. Yeah? Just a few examples, maybe to give you some inspiration of what it really means, what kind of effects you can get if you combine data. And we've built this small Apex application in which we track all of the hours that we work for our clients. So here we see the hourly rate, we see the number of hours, and of course the client that was done for. Now, based on this information, we can already of course create some reports based on what we expect that the end users will need. So we predefine those reports and we deliver them together with the Apex application. So in this case, we haven't done that with the standard Apex functionality, but we've used, of course, data visualization. So you see here that such reports can be integrated into the user interface of Apex. And on the left-hand side, we see the model. So this is the layer we defined on top of the Apex tables. I can create my own calculation to fix that problem, really. And so I would take the hourly rate, I would take the number of hours, multiply them, and just give it a name. So now that's done, I can just do Control C and Control V on the visualization, make a copy, and then I could change the first chart again to not look at number of hours, but to look at that new field, at the revenue. But let's see if we can distinguish that even better. And for that, I'm going to go to the advanced analytics option. So here we have a couple of things. For example, you see forecasting there in the bottom. That's really to predict, for example, the future trend of revenue, right? But in this case, I'm interested in clusters. I'm just clicking it to really highlight the groups that can be seen in the chart. So that data, of course, is not in the Apex application, and I'm going to take that from somewhere else. So let's have a look first at the possible data sources. Now all I still have to do is to create the link between the new data set and our Apex table. So on the left-hand side, I'm selecting our newly created column, the employee, and I'm linking it to the employee column from the Apex application. Let's have a look at how we integrate into the Apex application. So I'm here back into the BI Cloud service. And let's say I've just built this visualization. So I'm accessing this thing through the browser in this case. Now let's try to link this into an existing Apex application. Now maybe you want to specify some width and height parameters. And that really is all there's to it. And then if we scroll down a bit further, there is our new region. Okay, so then there's one other thing you need to do, or at least a one-time setup that you need to do to make the BI Cloud service, which we're using in this case, and Apex work together. Then, some implementation options. So, first of all, imagine you have on-premise your Apex application and you want to add a data visualization standalone also on-premise, in your data center or even on your premises. Now, it's probably a good idea that you don't let the DV users access the tables of your transactional Apex application directly. It's a good idea actually to create a separate schema and to create some views in that schema to create a bit of a layer of abstraction. And maybe you don't want to give access to all of your base tables either. And maybe you want to rename a few columns, etc.